Okay, now see earliest deadline, first scheduling. Here also three processes are given, T1, T2 and T3, and the capacity of T1 is 3 units, T2 is 2 units, T3 is 2 units. The deadline is 7, 4 and 8, where the period is 20, 5 and 10. Means T1 has to execute 3 capacity over a period of 20 units and the deadline is 7. T2 has to execute 2 units over a period of 5 with a deadline of 4. Means for every 5 units, it has to execute 2 units with the deadline of 4 units time. After immediately completion of 5, it will have 4 units of time. Within that 4 units, only it has to execute the 2 units. Now, for T3, it has to execute 2 units over a period of 10 with the deadline is 8. Okay? Now, we will take the LCM of these periods. Okay? Thereby, we can tell the algorithm in how many units we can execute. The LCM of 20, 5, 10, which is the period is 20. So we have to take at least 20 units consideration to execute this algorithm. So we have got this 20 units. Now we will start executing the algorithm. The main thing we should keep in mind is the deadlines. Deadlines we should not miss at any cost. Okay, so which is having the earliest deadline? T2. So which is the 4? Now it will start executing. So here T2, for every 5 intervals, this is 0 to 5, it has to execute 2 times. Then from 5 to 10, it has to execute 2 times. From 10 to 15, it has to execute 2 times. And from 15 to 20, it has to execute 2 times. This is clear, right? T2 will execute 4 times of 2 units each in 4 intervals. Because in 0 to 20 with period 5, we get 4 times. From 0 to 5 and 5 to 10 and 10 to 15 and 15 to 20. Right? Now, the next deadline is T1. So, from 0 to 20, it has to execute 3 units, but the deadline in here is 7. So, before 7, it should complete its execution. For the T2, before 4, it should complete execution of these 2 units. Here, before 9, it should complete execution of these 2 units. Here, before 14, it should complete the execution of these 2 units. Before 19, it has to complete execution of 2 units. Now, coming to the T3, from 0 to 10, it has to execute 2 units, but the deadline is 8. Here, the deadline is 8. Right? Now, from 10 to 20, because the interval is 10, it has to execute 2 units of capacity, but the deadline is plus 8. So 10 plus 8 is 18. Okay, now we should follow the deadline. Whichever having the first deadline will execute first. If you see this overall picture, T2 having the fourth deadline. So it has to execute these 2 units. So T2 will execute these 2 units, thereby this completes. So now this deadline is achieved. Now the next deadline is this thing, T1. T1, 7 is deadline, it has to execute 3 units. So it has to execute 3 units. T1 executed 3 units. And as T1 completed the execution, it will not participate in the further scheduling process, because the total capacity it has executed at a stretch in the first instance only. So it will not participate in the scheduling process. Now, the next target scheduling is this thing. This is achieved. Then this thing we have to achieve, T3. T3 deadline is 8. It has to execute 2 units. So now T3 will come here. It will execute from 5 to 7. T3 will come, thereby this is completed. Now the next deadline is 9. So it has to execute by the T2 2 units. So this is completed. Okay. Now from 0 to 9. First we scheduled T2 from 0 to 2. So thereby deadline is 4. So this is achieved. Next deadline is this thing, 7. So for achieving 7, we need to execute 3 units of T1. So from 2 to 5, T units of T1 is executed. Thereby, this is achieved. Then from 5, the deadline 8 we have to achieve. Before deadline 8, we need to execute this T3. So T3 executed for 2 units, thereby this constraint is achieved. Now the next deadline is 9. So we need to execute T2. T2 is executed for 2 units from 7 to 9. T2 is achieved. So from 9 to 10, nothing is there to execute. From 10, the next deadline is C14. So they have T2 has to execute for 2 more times. From 10 to 12, T2 will be executed, thereby this is achieved. The next deadline is 18. So T3 has to execute from 12 to 15. Okay, T3, sorry, 12 to 14 only it will execute, because only 2 units, no? T3 will execute for only 2 units, thereby this is achieved. So T3 has executed 2 units here, this is achieved, and 2 units here, this is achieved. Okay, the next only deadline remaining is T2, that is 19th one. So it will execute from 15 to 17, thereby T2, this is also achieved. Now you have to see every tick mark. See, from 0 to 2, this is achieved before deadline. Okay, from 2 to 5, T1 is executed because T7 is the deadline, this is achieved. From 5 to 7, T3 should be executed for 2 units, this is achieved. Before 8 only T3 is done. So if you observe at each instance, T2 is completed before 4. We will see T2 is completed before 4. Okay, next deadline is 8. T3 should be completed before 8. See here T3, it is completed before 8 only. It completed at 7 only. Okay, the next deadline is 9. T2 is completed before 9. That is true. Now this thing, T2 should be completed before 14. T2 is completing before 14 only. The next deadline is 18. So T3 completed before 18. So this is completed before 18. Now T2, it has to complete before 19. This is also completed. This is the way in which we can use earliest deadline first scheduling algorithm. First, we should note down what are the process with the capacity, deadline and period. Now, we should make a timeline of 20 units. Why 20 units? Because we should take the LCM of this period. So LCM of 20, 5, 10 is 20 units. So distribute them. Now, you have to note the deadline for this respective period. So T2, there is 4 deadline for every 5 intervals, 5 units. So 0 to 5, 4 is the deadline, 5 to 10, 9 is the deadline, 10 to 15, 14 is the deadline, 15 to 9, 20, 19 is the deadline. Likewise, for T1, 0 to 20, 7 is the deadline. For T3, 0 to 10, 8 is the deadline, 10 to 20, 18 is the deadline. So we should schedule in such a way that it has to execute before the deadline only. So this is how we can solve the earliest deadline first algorithm. Thank you.